Hi, welcome to my video using the output journal in Microsoft Dynamics Nav in order to create capacity ledger entries and put in quantities and costs into our release production orders. So first thing that we want to do is we want to search for the output journal in Nav so that we can find the release production order and enter in our work center, machine center time. So we open up to a screen looking similar to this. It's called the output journal. We have a batch name, which is our default. However, you could create multiple batches if you had multiple people entering in your output for the day. The first thing we want to do is enter in our posting date for the day that the capacity was done, whether to the work center or machine center. From the drop-down list, we want to select the specific production order that we want to add the time to. The document number likely will fill in because it's associated to the number series on the batch. However, if it doesn't, you can just enter in some kind of reference for auditing to that field as it is mandatory. The next thing we want to do is we want to select our item number. So from the lookup, unless we're using families, it's the only item that will be there. Then we want to select which operation. So which work center or machine center the work was done. So in this case, I'll just add some time to our rim assembly. And as you can see, it defaults in the rim assembly description. The next thing we want to toggle over is to our runtime. Now here's where we want to indicate, and as you can see in minutes, how much time was done on the rim assembly operation on the 13th of March in this case. So I'm going to say that it ran for 25 minutes. You can also set up times, wait times, move times, etc. on the output journal. For the purposes of this example, I'm just going to enter in runtime. But in your organization, you may use setup time, you may use wait and move time. And again, you would just fill in the respective fields the same way as I've done for the run. On the output quantity, I can indicate how many of the loudspeakers or the end item that I'm producing were created. So in this scenario, I'm just going to indicate that we completed two. If any were scrapped throughout the process for whatever purpose, maybe it was training, maybe there was a machine issue, you can indicate a scrap quantity. And then you also have the ability, if you choose your columns, if you so choose, you could put in a scrap code, which is something that can be defined by your organization to indicate why things were scrapped. And then at the end of the year, you can do some analysis to figure out, you know, if there's ways to improve things. You can also enter in a different unit of measure code if you need to. You can indicate if the product was finished. So say, for example, on this line, the rim assembly, all the work was done that needed to be done. I could indicate that as finished. I could indicate which work shift it was done on, first shift, second shift. And again, I could use that later for reporting. Once I've entered in all of my time against the line, I can come up to my ribbon here and I can select to post. It will ask me, do I want to post the journal lines? In this scenario, I do, so I will say yes. It tells me that my journal lines were successfully posted, and then the journal line will clear. So if I want to take a look at, for example, the production order capacity ledger entries now, by adding the order number again, I can come up to my ribbon and select entries. And I could look at the capacity ledger entries. So I should see the entry that I just created for 25 minutes where I produced two of the front wheel. So I can see that here. On the production order, I have the ability to see that on the 13th, there was some production done for 25, and I outputted two. I can also see the cost that went in based on that and what entry it was associated to. If I am not in the output journal and I was on the release production order, I could also look at the capacity that was done to help me find out where things were done on my shop floor. So by doing that, I've gone back to my home screen and now I'm just going to search for released production order. I can navigate to the job, so I could use the filter key if I needed to come to the job that I was looking at. And then from the ribbon, you'll see that I've got entries. So I can drop that down, and because I've used the output journal, I would like to see the capacity ledger entries because the output journal is going to create a capacity ledger entry so that I have the ability to see how my machine centers and work centers are doing and where my production is for this part. So I open that up, and we see that we have the same view that we had when we opened up this screen from the output journal. It was just a different way to get to the same information. But here I can see that there was some work done on the 15th, and there was some work done again in March. And as you start posting output more and more into this job, this will dynamically just update for you. And then from there, I can also look at the statistics on the job, and I can see again the capacity costs, and I can see the 3240, which was 240 from my 1214 or 1215 capacity ledger entry that was created that we saw, and then the $30 that was put in because of the capacity ledger entry I just created with you now. So that's using Microsoft Dynamics Nav to create an output journal entry to create capacity ledger entries. Thanks so much for watching.